Thank you. Fire exits are located at the sides of the room, in the front and back. In the event of a fire, you will hear a fire alarm. At that time, please move in a calm and orderly fashion to the nearest exit. Thank you. I'd now like to make a motion for public speaking. No speaker cards. Thank you. I continue on with information reports from the superintendent.
Thank you so very much, President Grossman. Good evening to the board and to the community. Our superintendent's report for Tuesday, September 4th, 2018. This is the cover to our calendar that went out to our parents, and we are excited about the timeliness of the calendar and the fact that it features our students and the events and activities planned by our staff. And you will notice in the middle it says rise up. So we're building on that theme. Last year we said going all the way up, and now we're saying and beyond. Our mission statement, everyone, as a unified community, the East Ramapo Central School District is committed to educating the whole child by providing a healthy, safe, supportive, engaging, and challenging learning environment. Our vision statement, we will become proficient in all that we do. Our five-point plan, which really is educating the whole child. We want staff and students who are healthy, safe, supported, engaged, and challenged. Our goals, success in the early years, healthy, safe, supported, engaged, and challenged. Motivated, confident, empowered, critical thinkers, mastery of academic subjects, high school graduation, and readiness for college and careers. I would like to show a video of our 2018 summer academies. That was our health and sciences. This is robotics. Our students enjoyed their experience this summer during the summer academies. We had 2,000 students, approximately 2,000 students to participate. And now our back to school video that was sent out today on social media and shared with our teachers as they gathered for the superintendent's conference day, our back to school video.
Hello, this is Dr. Deborah Wortham, Superintendent, East Ramapo Central School District. Welcome to the 2018-2019 school year. We're going all the way up and beyond. This summer, we have had the glorious opportunity of hosting over 2,000 students in our summer academies. Our students have been involved in robotics, they've been involved in the sciences, healthcare experiences, over 400 students involved in our music academy. What an outstanding adventure.
Ready, set, go!
An amazing part of our summer learning, our eighth graders, rising ninth graders, had an opportunity to participate in our Summer Bridge program. They were so anxious to share their hall of affirmations. Oh my God. There are so many things that happen during the summer that prepare us for the opening day of school. You've seen so many of our roofs were being repaired. So many of our schools received new windows. We have our athletic fields that are near completion. Our football teams are already practicing for the fall season. This is a great time to be a part of the East Ramapo Central School District.
Your thoughts?
It's time to react.
Think you can?
Work hard, get smart.
Every day find out how great you
can be.
Young people, remember, your thoughts determine your actions. All summer long, you were thinking and you were believing that you were going to be successful. And now, when the doors open in September, we're ready for more learning for you. Are you ready? I'm ready. Welcome to the 2018-2019 school year.
So in this welcome back video, we wanted to focus on the funds that we have used wisely with the bond to give the community an update on the where we are. We are planning now to have, we had the ribbon cutting ceremony for Spring Valley High School, and now we're planning for Ramapo High School. And just to give the community just a snapshot of where their money is and where it went to date. And so we are just so excited about the opening of school and how the students at CACIAC, remember that was the vision of our initial set of monitors to create K-8 schools and to reduce some of the transitions. We've moved forward, and to have theme schools. We've moved forward with CACIAC, we've partnered with sister schools. So we're really still on point with the 19 recommendations from that initial report and moving forward. So for that, we are ready to open school on tomorrow. It's been very quiet. We saw some parents registering students today. We had our band playing and our teachers received the superintendent's message today of staying the course, getting stronger, better, and smarter, and continue to rise up for our students, for our students. So with that ends the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Dr. Rhythm. Moving on, I'd like to make a motion for consent agenda items. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Berkowitz, I think that was. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Abstention, motion passes. Action items from the board. Motion.
Well, I have a question on B. B1. But the use of district credit cards.
Look, we're not quite up to that yet.
So. I'm sorry.
Hold on a second. Hold that thought. Internal audit reports. A motion to accept the final internal audit reports, which incorporated the modifications that the board asked for at the last meeting. I'll make a motion to accept the internal audit reports. Second. Second by Mr. Freeman. Excuse me. All in favor say aye. Opposition, abstention, motion passes. Items from the superintendent, I believe there's one addendum. I have that the addendum was on the other part, so I forget what it said. It's 1-10. I have a motion.
Can I ask the question?
Motion first and second, then discussion.
Okay.
So do I have a motion for items 1-10 from the superintendent?
Motion.
Moved by Mr. Weissmandel. So one here, I don't need a letter. Do I have a second? Second by Mr. Charles. Discussion. Mr. Berkowitz.
Okay, thank you. I'm not a great frequent flyer, but when I go, on attachment B, that means it says that no employee raising this or any other person shall receive any benefits associated with it.
Is your microphone?
Yes, it is. I hear something. Including mileage or points. I had once heard that it came up with a question of someone working for a corporation. The corporation buys the tickets. And the question was, who gets the points, the corporation or the flyer? And my understanding was that they give points, they go to the person who's actually taking the seat and not to the corporation. I don't know if that's true or not, but if it is, that might affect the way we word this statement here. You know,
Mr. Berkowitz, can I go back and ask you to restate that? But first let me state what I think you heard. What I think I heard you say, that when we take trips, whoever, for instance, if we're flying on Southwest, whoever flies, they get the points? Is that what you mean?
I have no problem with it, it's just the way it's written.
Not to make sure I understand
yes.
What you're saying.
Yes. If the district pays for the ticket, the district doesn't get the points, so to speak. It goes to the person who has the seat in their name. So we can't have something in here that says that the employee cannot get any benefit with the usage of the card, such as frequent flyer mileage or points. I just want to make sure that it's not a legal thing, not a problem. I have no problem with the employee getting the points or the district getting the points. But then if there is a question as to how that point system works, and it's different, you know, whatever it's hotels, flying, whatever, that we're not saying something here that's either against the law or against general policy.
I'll refer to Walter, but I think what it's referring to is when you charge something very often with the charge, you get points for the value of the charge. That's not happening here. Not the flight per se, but for example, when you charge something, you get mileage points for the value of the charge that's coming on. Here you're not. It's the card belongs to the district, not to the person.
This is for you to work out, just being up a question. I'm going to answer the last question.
We have a motion and we have a second. We will do the vote on items 1 to 10. All in favor of items 1 to 10?
Aye. I need to abstain on number 9.
Street burden is abstaining on item number 9.
Are there any other abstentions, or everybody else was yes?
Yes. I think everything yes. Moving on. Information reports from the board are of this evening. Discussion items from the superintendent. None. And the advanced planning and meeting dates. Regular meeting is scheduled for Monday, September 17th, beginning at 7:30 p.m. in this room. It's a Monday.
It's a Monday because of the holidays?
Which are every week. There is no executive session this evening. Any letters or communications? None. I think we're going to set, I guess, a couple of records this evening. I'll make a motion to adjourn this meeting. Second by Mr. Charles Evans. All in favor, say aye. Motion passes.